The first value that we are looking at is blood hemoglobin level. 74 hemoglobin is lower than normal. Decrease in hemoglobin concentration we call anemia, and once we see anemia, we have to determine how severe is the anemia, and which type of anemia is it according to the size of red blood cells. So, how severe is the anemia? In order to tell this, we have to know two values. It's 110 and 80. So, normal hemoglobin level for male is 130-160. From 110 to lower limit of normal is mild anemia. From 80 to 110 is moderate anemia. And lower than 80 is severe anemia. So, in this case, hemoglobin value is 74. So, it's severe anemia. The type of anemia according to the size of red blood cells we determine by MCV. With MCV we have to know two values, it's 100 and 80. The red blood cells with MCV between 80 and 100 called normocytes, greater than 100 macrocytes, and less than 80 microcytes. In this case MCV is 119, so it's macrocytes. Thereby, it's severe macrocytic anemia. Usually, when hemoglobin is low, red blood cells are low. And in this case, red blood cells 1.93, which is lower than normal. The next value is platelets. Platelets are 128, which is lower than normal. With platelets, we have to know two values. It's 150. From lower limit of normal to 100, it's mild thrombocytopenia. From 100 to 50, moderate, and lower than 50, it's severe. In this case, platelets are 108, so it's mild thrombocytopenia. The next value are white blood cells. As we see, white blood cell count is 4.9, which is normal. White blood cells is a collective term that includes a few types of cells. So now we have to see maybe some cells that we include into white blood cells are elevated. And there are three major possibilities. White blood cells consist of three major groups of cells. It's blast cells, lymphocytes, and myelocytes. Myelocytes consist of neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, and monocytes. The first cells that we are looking at are blasts, because in normal state there are no blast cells in peripheral blood. And here blast cells are zero, so it's perfectly normal. The next cells are lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are 16%, which is also normal. In myelocytes, first of all, we are looking at neutrophils. Segmented forms are normal, bands normal, metamyelocytes normal, and myelocytes normal. So, all forms of neutrophils are perfectly normal. After neutrophils, we are looking at basophils. Basophils are normal. Eosinophils are also normal, and monocytes are normal. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate is also within normal range. So, it's severe macrocytic anemia accompanied by mild thrombocytopenia. Now, we have to determine the type of macrocytic anemia. And there are two possibilities. Macrocytic anemia can be caused by B12 deficiency, or it can be caused by folate deficiency. First of all, we check folate level and the level of B12. In this case, folate level is normal, but B12 is low. So it's B12 deficiency anemia. Typically, it's enough, but in some cases, to say for sure, we have to determine the level of methylmalonic acid and the level of homocysteine. In this case, the level of methylmalonic acid is significantly elevated and the level of homocysteine is also elevated. Elevation of both of them tell us it's B12 deficiency anemia. Because in folate deficiency, obviously folate level will be low and here only the level of homocysteine will be increased. Methylmalonic acid will be normal. So, in our case, it's B12 deficiency anemia. The next step is to determine the cause of anemia. The most common factors are diet and antibodies to intrinsic factor. So we have to exclude antibodies as a potential cause. In this case, antibodies to parietal cells are significantly elevated. The problem with vegan diet as a potential cause is that it usually takes 3 to 5 years for B12 deficiency to develop, simply because we have huge stores of B12 in the liver. B12 deficiency anemia that is caused by autoantibodies to parietal cells we call pernicious anemia.